Good morning, everybody. Jonathan Knoll here with Pastor Deborah Valentin Carnish, who will be bringing you a brief message. Welcome to these devotions for Thursday morning, and we will begin right away by singing I Surrender All. All to Jesus I surrender, all to Him I freely give. I will ever love and trust Him, in His presence daily live. I surrender all, I surrender all. All to Thee, my blessed Savior, I surrender all. All to Jesus I surrender, make me Savior wholly Thine. May Thy Holy Spirit fill me, may I know Thy power divine. I surrender all, I surrender all to Thee, my blessed Savior, I surrender all. All to Jesus I surrender, Lord, I give myself to Thee. Fill me with Thy love and power, let Thy blessing fall on me. I surrender all, I surrender all. All to Thee, my blessed Savior, I surrender all. Turn your eyes upon Jesus. Light for a look at the Savior, and life more abundant and free. Turn your eyes upon Jesus, look full in His wonderful face, and the things of earth will grow strangely dim in the light of His glory and grace. Through death into life everlasting, He passed and we follow Him there. Over us sin no more hath dominion, for more than conquerors we are. Turn your eyes upon Jesus, look full in His wonderful face, and the things of earth will grow strangely dim in the light of His glory and grace. His word shall not fail you, He promised, believe Him, and all will be well. Then go to a world that is dying. His perfect salvation to tell. Turn your eyes upon Jesus. Look full in His wonderful face. And the things of earth will grow strangely dim in the light of His glory and grace.
Good morning on this snowy morning. We have entered into our season of Lent, and today I'd like to kind of share. We've had conversations, colleagues of mine, and we talked about the feeling of Lent continuing. We kind of never felt like we ever got out of Lent from last year. The virus came and things shut down, and we kind of feel like we've had that Lenten heaviness about us for the past year. So today, I'd like to talk a little bit about reflection. Reflection in a season of Lent. Many of us over the past year have had a lot of reflection, a lot of frustrations, a lot of losses, and a lot of looking deep within to find ways to not only survive, but find ways to thrive during our time of isolation and being alone. Some folks have developed new habits or hobbies, ones that they could do more alone than in a group setting. Others have learned languages. Some have started the piano. There's all sorts of different things that people have used to, quote unquote, pass the time. Lent is a time where we take for self-reflection. Historically, we give up something or we add something that would enrich our lives spiritually. This year, for this day, I'd like to take a look at a psalm. It's a Psalm 107, and it reminds us to give thanks to God for the deliverance. But before we give thanks, we must recognize the darkness which is in each and every one of us. Hear the reading of a psalm. Give thanks to the Lord, for He is good, and His mercy endures forever. So let the redeemed of the Lord say so. He redeemed from the hand of the enemy, and He gathered out of the lands from the east and the west and the north and from the south. You see, they wandered in the wilderness in a desolate way. They found no city to dwell in. They were hungry and thirsty, and their soul fainted in them. And then they cried out to the Lord in their trouble, and He delivered them out of their distress. And He led them forth by the right way, that they may go to a city for a dwelling place. Those who sat in darkness and in the shadow of death, that were bound in affliction and iron, therefore He brought their heart with labor. Then they cried out to the Lord in their trouble, and He saved them out of their distresses. He brought them out of darkness and out of the shadow of death and broke their chains in pieces. Oh, that men would give thanks to the Lord for His goodness. Here ends the reading from the psalm. Do you know we're brought out of our darkness? Lent is a time where we look within ourselves, and yes, we are celebratory because we know Easter's coming. And yet, we feel the heaviness of the Christ as he walked through the wilderness. As human beings, we have darkness within us, and we also have light. There's a quote that says, "Life can only be understood backwards, but must be then lived forwards." Life must be lived backwards so we can move forward. What is it in our hearts today? What is it in our souls that we can reflect on? Is there darkness in our hearts? Are there frustrations that we don't know how to lay down? Is there anger, bitterness, the lack of self-control? What are the things that we can recognize that we have had in our past or that we currently have that we can let go of during this season of reflection? For as we let go in looking backwards, we can then look ahead and move forwards. You see, we know the end of the story. We know redemption. But we practice the season of Lent for renewal. And as we reflect, may we be reminded that it's not just as a mirror reflects, but it's a reflection of the heart and of the soul. So may we look there today. May we ask God for his forgiveness and be reminded that he will never let us go. So let's live like it. Amen.
And we pray together this prayer, "Have thine own way, Lord." Have thine own way, Lord, have thine own way. Thou art the potter, I am the clay. Mold me and make me after thy will. While I am waiting, yielded and still. Have thine own way, Lord, have thine own way. Search me and try me, Master, today. Whiter than snow, Lord, wash me just now, as in thy presence humbly I bow. Have thine own way, Lord, have thine own way. Wounded and weary, help me, I pray. Power, all power, surely is thine. Touch me and heal me, Savior divine. Have thine own way, Lord, have thine own way. Hold o'er my being absolute sway. Fill with thy spirit till all shall see Christ only, always living in me.
And finally, we will sing together "As the Deer."
deer panteth for the water, so my soul longeth after thee. You alone are my heart's desire, and I long to worship thee. You alone are my strength and shield, to you alone may my spirit yield. You alone are my heart's desire, and I long to worship thee. You're my friend and you are my brother, even though you are a king. I love you more than any other, so much more than anything. You alone are my strength and shield, to you alone may my spirit yield. You alone are my heart's desire, and I long to worship thee. I want you more than gold or silver, only you can satisfy. You alone are the real joy giver and the apple of my eye. You alone are my strength and shield, to you alone may my spirit yield. You alone are my heart's desire, I long to worship thee.
Let us close with a word of prayer. Let us pray. Gracious and merciful God, we are grateful for your redemption. And yet we continue to recognize within each of us that we have darkness. And we ask that you continue to come within our hearts and to continue to instill your love, your mercy, and your grace, that we may live out our days in the love that you have shown us as we offer it one to another. In Christ's name we pray. Amen.